with the creation of an object, the time gets created, because the object comes into existence at a particular time. That's when the time starts. As long as it goes on and once it gets destroyed, that is the end of the time. That's how the time gets created. Otherwise, that time is also an imagination, just like this world is an imagination or a matter is an imagination. Just like your mind, when your mind is there, it is eternal. You don't know when it got created. You are already there. So there the time concept doesn't work. There is no such thing that your mind started now and it will be destroyed after some time. That's when the time concept comes. But it's not so. But when the mind imagines an object, that object comes under the periphery of time. Because once you imagine an object appeared in your mind, the time started, birth has happened. Until you don't withdraw that object from your mind or you make it vanish by ignoring or becoming quiet, so that is there, the time moves, keeps moving. And when that matter also disappears, the time also ends. For the mind itself, there is no time because it was never created and it's not going to end. That is how the time and space, both we keep talking sometimes, both are imagination. The same space which I was explaining, not the actual space itself as imagination. So when we imagine there is a distance between you and me, this space is what is imagination, and the time also is imagination.